This video is sponsored by AJuice. Hey guys, once again, welcome to the new video. In this video, we are going to create a clean and elegant slideshow animation inside of Adobe After Effects. This tutorial is going to be super easy and super fun. You can use these motion graphics in your video editing project to make them stand out. I am Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's jump right into After Effects and get started. Let's go. Alright guys, so this is Adobe After Effects, and let's start by creating a new composition. It is very simple. Click on this new composition button, or you can just go over here and take a new composition, and this is gonna be our main composition. You can also call it render comp. I'm gonna use the size 1920 in width, 1080 in height, which is a full HD resolution, frame rate 60, duration make it 5 seconds long, background color black, hit OK. And now let's create a gray background. So just go to layer, go to new and take a new solid layer. Here we have to select the gray color, something like this, hit OK. And I'm gonna call it busy because this is gonna be the background, hit OK. And now let's animate the gray background. So it is very simple. Select the background layer, hold control on the keyboard, and this is the rectangle tool. So just double click on this rectangle tool to create a mask just like that. And then just go to 2 seconds, open the mask property. This is the mask path. Turn on the stopwatch button and lock these control points as it is. And then just go to very first frame of this animation, highlight these two control points, hold shift on the keyboard, press left arrow key, and place these control points outside of the frame, just like that. And now we have a linear animation, something like this. Highlight both the keyframes, hit F9 to easy ease the keyframe. And now let's create a smooth graph. So highlight these keyframes, go to graph editor. If your graph editor not looking like this, then right click on that and check this option, edit a speed graph. Highlight this point, hold this handle and drag it on the left hand side and create a nice smooth animation as you can see. Now you can close the graph editor, close the layer. Perfect. And then we have to create a white background. So just go to layer again, go to new and take a new solid layer. This time we have to select the white color from here, hit OK. I'm gonna call it white background. So this is the white background. We have to repeat the same thing. Select the white background, hold control on the keyboard and double click on this rectangle tool. And then just go to 2 seconds, open the mask property, turn on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the mask path, and highlight these two control points, hold shift on the keyboard, press left arrow key, and set these control points right over here, just like that. Perfect. And then just go to very first frame of this animation, highlight these two control points, hold shift and press right arrow key, and set these two control points right over here. We have to select all the control points, hold shift on the keyboard, press right arrow key and set these control points outside of the frame. Perfect. And then we will get this type of a linear animation. Obviously we have to create a smooth animation, so highlight both the keyframes. Either you can hit F9 on the keyboard or right click on the keyframe, go to keyframe assistant, and this is the option easy ease. And then just go to graph editor, highlight these points, drag this handle on the left hand side, and basically we will get this type of smooth animation. Perfect. After that you can close the graph editor, and then we have to import any image or video file. So just go to the project window, right click on that, go to import file and select any image or video file. So in this case I'm using this image that I have downloaded from unsplash.com. basically you can use any image or video file, whatever you like. Click on import. I'm going to create a separate media composition for this image or video file. So just go to the composition, take a new composition, and we have to reset the width and height. So I'm going to set the width value 700 and height value something around 700. Leave the other setting as it is, hit OK. And this is the media composition. I'm going to place the image inside of this media composition. Hit S on the keyboard to bring out the scale property. Let's scale it down a bit and fit the image inside of the media composition, just like that. Perfect. Now we have to create one more composition. So just right click on this image, click on the pre-compose, check this option, move all attributes into the new composition, and this is going to be the image composition, so I'm going to call it image. Hit OK, and now let's create animation on this image composition. So just go to the end of this animation, hit S on the keyboard to bring out the scale property, turn on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe, and lock the value 100% at the end of this animation. Then just go to half a second on the frame number 30, and let's increase the size of this image composition. So I'm going to set the value 175 or 180, and now we have something like this. Highlight both the keyframes, hit F9 to easy ease them, go to your graph editor. Obviously we have to create smooth graph, so highlight this point, hold this handle and drag it on the left hand side, and then we will get this type of smooth zoom out animation. Perfect. And then just go to the render composition. Here we have to import the media placeholder inside of the render composition, which is our main composition. Before we proceed further, let's take a look at the amazing pack I Want It All bundle from AEJuice. It is one of the best template pack for Adobe After Effects. This pack includes premium as well as free tools and plugin for After Effects that hopefully increase your production and save you so much time and efforts. Some elements of this pack including seamless transitions, shape elements, whiteboard animation, text preset, and much more for absolutely free. All the links given in the description, please check this out. Now let's place this image right over here by holding shift. Perfect. And then we have to add one more animation for this image or media placeholder. So select the media placeholder or media composition, hold control on the keyboard, and here we have the rectangle tool. So double click on this rectangle and add a rectangular mask on it. Open the mask property, go to 2 second. Here we have the mask expansion, so turn on the stopwatch button and lock the mask expansion value 0 pixels at 2 seconds and go to half a second. Here we have to set the mask expansion negative 300 maybe, or maybe negative 350, and make it like this, alright? And here we have something like this. Perfect. Highlight both the keyframe, hit F9 to easy ease them, go to your graph editor, highlight this point and drag it on the left hand side and create nice and smooth animation. Perfect. You can close the graph editor, close the layer. And after that we have to add some text and asset over here. So first of all we have to create blends. So this is the rectangle tool, select the rectangle tool, click on fill, set it to solid color, click on stroke and set it to none, select the fill color maybe pure white, hit OK, and let's create a rectangular shape just like that by holding shift, maybe like this. All right, open the rectangle, and here we have this rectangle size. So I'm gonna set the rectangle size maybe 180 or 190 pixels. Perfect. And we have to do one more thing, just select the shape layer 1. Here we have the anchor point. I'm gonna set the anchor point in the center of this shape. So select the move tool, hold control on the keyboard, select the layer, and this is the pan behind tool. Simply double click on this pan behind tool and set the anchor point in the center. Now let's place the shape right over here. After that we have to convert this rectangular shape into blends. So what we have to do, select the shape layer 1, go to effect and preset. If you don't have the effect and preset, then go to window and check this option, effect and preset. Now we have to search blend. So simply type blend, or you can also call it Venetian blend. Drag and drop the Venetian blend on this rectangular shape. And here we have to do some settings. So this is the transition completion. I'm going to set the transition completion value 85%. And this is the direction. So I'm going to set the value 118 degree. Perfect. And this is the width. I'm going to set the value 16 or 18 maybe. And now we have a perfect blend kind of shape. It is looking nice. All right. And we have to animate the blend. So just go to 1.5 second. Select the shape layer 1, which is the blend. Hit P on the keyboard to bring out the position. I want to bring out the opacity as well. So hold shift and press T on the keyboard to bring out the opacity as well. So first of all, we have to lock the position and opacity as it is. So turn on the stopwatch button for position and the opacity at 1.5 second. Just go to 0.5 second right over here and set the opacity 0%, and let's change the position of this rectangle something like this. I'm going to set the value 650. Perfect. Now we will get this type of animation. As you can see, select all the keyframes, hit F9 to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor, highlight this point and drag these handles on the left hand side, and now we have nice and smooth animation. Perfect. Now you can close the layer and graph editor. Perfect. After that, we have to create a duplicate of this. So select the shape layer, hit Control D to duplicate. First of all, we have to remove the position animation. So select the second copy, hit P on the keyboard, turn off the stopwatch button. All right. And then you can drag these blend and place it in this corner right over here. All right. But we have to change the color as well. So this is the fill option. Click on that, select the black color, and let's down the opacity first. So hit T on the keyboard to open the opacity parameter. Just go to 1.5 second where we have created a keyframe right over here. Place the CDI on it and let's change the opacity value to 30%. And now it is looking like this. You can also add the position animation. So just go to 1.5 second, select the layer, hit P on the keyboard to bring out the position property. Turn on the stopwatch button to lock the position as it is. Go to 0.5 second and drag the shape on the right hand side. And now we will get something like this. Select all the keyframes, hit F9 to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor, simply drag this handle on the left hand side. And now we have smooth animation. After that, we have to add some text on it. It is very important. So what we have to do, select the text tool first. Here we have to type a number. So just go to character. Here we have to select a font style. So in this case, I'm using Babus New Pro font style. I'm gonna select the color pure black. And I'm gonna set the size of the text maybe 500 pixel. Line spacing auto. Click over here and type a number. So this is our first slide. So I'm gonna type number 01. Perfect. And we have to do one more thing. Just align the text on the left hand side. So this is the paragraph. I'm gonna click on this button, left align text. And then we have to set the text right over here. You can also draw a line for reference. So hit R on the keyboard to bring out the ruler. And here you can take a reference line, set it like this, and you can place these objects or assets according to the guideline. Perfect. Now you can set the anchor point in the center as well. So it's very simple. Select the text layer, hold Control and double click on the span behind tool. It is very important. Now select the text, hit T on the keyboard to bring out the opacity. I'm gonna set the opacity 10% and blend the text like this. Now just go to 2 second, turn on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the opacity parameter. Go to 1 second and set the opacity 0%. Perfect. So we have this type of opacity animation on it. After that, we have to create our main text over here. That is very important. So select the text, and this time we have to change the font style. So in this case, I'm using a different font style, which is the Barlow font style. This font is free, I think. And now let's down the size. I'm gonna set the value something around 100 pixel. Click over here and type anything, whatever you like, just like that. Hit Control A to highlight all, and let's increase the size of the text. You can set it to regular or maybe semi bold, whatever you like. And I'm gonna place the text right over here, just like that. And for this one, we have to align it to the left hand side, which is very important. So click on the paragraph left align. You can set the character spacing as well. So I'm gonna set it to -30, or maybe you can change semi bold to bold. Now let's do the main thing with the text, which is the animation, which is very important. So open the text layer, and this is the animation. So what we have to do, just go to 2 second or maybe 2.5 second right over here. First of all, we have to add some property. Just go to animate, click over here, add the position property, and not only the position, but I'm gonna add the opacity as well as the tracking. So just click on the add button, go to property and add the opacity first, and then add the tracking. And after that, we have to do some setting with this. So first of all, we have to change the position. Let's set down the position. I'm gonna set the value 60 or maybe 75. Perfect. And this is the opacity. Let's change the opacity to 0. And this is the tracking amount. I'm gonna set the value negative 60. And open the range selector here. We have to create a keyframe at 2.5 seconds. So this is the start. I'm gonna set the start value 100. Turn on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the start property, and just go to 0.5 seconds. And let's set the start value 0. So basically we will get this type of animation, but obviously it is not looking good. So highlight both the keyframe, hit F9 to easy ease them, go to your graph editor, and this is the graph. So first of all, we have to set the CTI, which is the playhead. Place this playhead or CTI in the center of these two keyframes. Highlight this point and drag it on the right hand side, and highlight this one, drag it to the left hand side. Perfect. And then you can see the difference here. We have nice and smooth animation. Now you can close the layer, close the graph editor, select the text, and I'm gonna set the text maybe semi bold, which is looking nice. All right, and after that we have to add more text over here. So select the text tool. This time we have to change the size. I'm gonna set the value 30, character spacing 0. I'm gonna set the style medium. Perfect. Click over here and type a description. Just like that. After that, select these learn more text and select the style semi bold, I think, and select these two lines and change the color, maybe a gray color, light gray color maybe. Perfect. Hit OK. Now I'm gonna place this description right over here. You can take one more guideline from here and set it like this, and according to that I'm gonna place this text. And now let's animate this text. So what we have to do, just go to 1.5 second, select the text layer, hit T to bring out the opacity, turn on the stopwatch button, go to 0.5 second and set the opacity 0. So now we will get something like this. I'm gonna adjust these keyframes, maybe just go to 1 second and drag these two keyframes right over here. And then we have to add one more text. Select the text tool, click over here and type your website. Hit Ctrl A to highlight all, and for this one I'm gonna use the white color. Let's align it to the right hand side and place this text right over here. Perfect. Now we have to animate this one as well. So just go to 2.5 second, hit T to bring out the opacity, turn on the stopwatch button to lock the opacity value 100, and just go to 1 second back in time, maybe 1.5 second or maybe 1 second, and set the opacity 0%. And now it is almost done. So just go to very first frame of this animation, turn on the motion blur for all layers, and let's have a look. Perfect, right? And that's all for this tutorial. If you have any question or thoughts, feel free to leave a comment below this video. And if you are new to my channel, consider subscribing and giving this video a thumbs up to show your love and support. My name is Vikash Kumar, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye-bye.